Right, we're back, and it looks like we've got loads of people to speak to. Let's go to this scroll first.
It's mine, and mine alone.
Right, so it looks like it's upstairs where we've got to go.
Wildlings for more than a week. We came upon two of their scouts and followed them.
These are all the members of the Night's Watch.
Look how they're gorging themselves. I've always wondered where Bowen Marsh finds the food to feed us all.
Good old Mormont.
Jaw, Lothar told me that you wanted to see me as soon as I arrived.
Yes. One of Quarren the Halfhand's men arrived before you and told me what happened at Icemark. Have you found Poddy or his remains?
No, he was a naughty boy.
Poddy deserted. I tracked him down in the forest north of Molestown and managed to kill him just as he was attacking a young girl. I also took care of a couple of cutthroats I came across as they prepared to ambush passers-by.
Raiders so near to Castle Black. If only we had enough men to send more patrols deep into the gift. So, not a single one of these green boys will have survived his first day as a brother of the Night's Watch. I know enough about what happened there for now. Mors, there is another matter we must discuss. I don't know if you noticed the soldiers with the blue tabards downstairs. They're the men of John Arryn, the King's Hand.
Ah, the men you told me about before I left for Icemark. Those who came to meet me.
Yes. According to their message, they were looking for one of the heroes of Stag's Mount. You are the only one here who fits that description.
Do we know more about what they want from me?
Yes. They brought me a letter written by John Arryn. I'll let you read it. You can see for yourself what it's about.
Right, dear friend, sorry to write to you. I'll let you guys read all of this. You can pause it. Right, so I've got to meet a girl.
Arryn, that sly old fox hasn't changed a whit. 15 years without a word, and all of a sudden he writes to beg a favor of me. I'm not even surprised.
Why are you receiving a personal missive from the King's Hand?
He's an old friend. We fought side by side in Robert Baratheon's rebellion. He saved my life more than once.
There is a passage that I don't understand. Mentions a girl, the Darkness, and your wife, Serena. What does it mean?
Arryn is an intelligent man. This is a message only I can decipher. During the war, when we fought together, I never once used the services of a whore. Arryn knew and would tease me for it. He liked to say that I feared the darkness that lurked in brothels. I would reply that the thought of my wife was sufficient to clear away any darkness. The girl he mentions in his letter must be hidden in a whorehouse. The only one I know of nearby is in Molestown. Old Arryn knows me well. 15 years later, I'm still faithful to my wife.
It is good that you honor the chastity of our order, Mors. But are you doing it for the right reasons? Our vows are clear. We must leave behind our wives and children. If you are true to your oath, it must not be out of love for Serena, but out of respect for the Night's Watch.
I was going to say that I thought that you couldn't have a wife if you were in the Night's Watch.
I know, Jor. We have spoken of this countless times, but I am unable to forget them.
Be that as it may, he must have felt seriously threatened to write such a cryptic message. This does not bode well. I conferred with his emissary, Sir Godric Donnelly. He convinced me that his mission did not conflict with our duties. And if we help them, Arryn will convince King Robert to send us the recruits, materials, and supplies that we so sorely lack. Molestown is in the gift under the jurisdiction of the Night's Watch. You have my authorization to go there with Sir Godric.
Thank you, Jor. I will finally be able to repay my debt to John Arryn.
Remember, Mors, the Night's Watch does not interfere in politics. If, for some reason, you suspect that something is wrong, return to Castle Black.
Very well. I will go find this Godric.
So, it looks like we're off to Molestown. It's quite cool, this little area. The dining hall, or whatever they call it. Ah, that's the guy.
I presume that you are John Arryn's men. The Lord Commander spoke to me about you.
Indeed. I am the Knight Godric Donnelly, and this is my Lieutenant, Jared. And you must be Sir Mors Westphal.
Indeed.
John Arryn described you as one of the true heroes of the Battle of Stag's Mount. Tis an honor to make your acquaintance.
I knew someone named Mors Westphal at one time, during the Baratheon Rebellion. A real son of a bitch, who I hold directly responsible for the death of my brother. I wouldn't have expected to find him at the Wall.
Hold your tongue, Jared. We're in Night's Watch territory here. Whatever our past quarrels, we're on a mission here. Please excuse this interruption, Sir Westphal. If you have read the letter, you must already know our reason for being here.
Yeah, I'm bored of this.
The girl John wrote of in his letter. I believe I know where she is.
Perfect. I knew we could count on you. Lord Arryn only gives his trust to men of great worth. Then tell me, sir, where is she?
According to the information given in the letter, the girl is most likely hiding in Molestown.
In Molestown? The village we passed along the King's Road?
Yes. To protect themselves from the constant cold outside, the inhabitants have built an underground passage. I will lead us there. We will no doubt find her there. Strangers are seldom seen in these parts. We'll ask the villagers about her.
Very well. Let us get on our way.
Hold on. I just received a raven with a message from King's Landing. Dark wings. Dark words.
What is it?
Let's go outside, Mors. I don't wish to speak of this in the common hall.
What's going on, Jor?
Very well. The King's Hand, John Arryn, is dead.
We're into way too many cutscenes territory again here. Okay, so we're gonna flip back to Alester then now. So I've got my armor on now. Still got that crazy hair. I wonder if there's a helmet I can equip. So, I've put my hood back on, which kind of hides the stupid hair at least. So, I'm not entirely sure where to go. I mean, there's people like that you can talk to, but there's just so many cutscenes in this game that it's kind of... I think it would bore you guys. So we'll just carry on.
Fires, latrines, and a tide as well. How could I forget such a bouquet?
Yeah, we'll only do the cutscenes that are necessary.
There he is, Axe. Just like I said.
Good job. I'll take care of him.
Think you're going somewhere, pretty boy?
I see that the cutthroat business continues to flourish.
You're not just talking to any old bandits here. We're called the Reapers. Now, Lord Sarwick will come with us quietly. I can be very unpleasant when there's too much noise.
Oh, God. Let's see if they'll just leave, if I bribe them.
Why go to the trouble? If it's my money you want, I have only a few coins on my person. Take them and leave me be. No one has to get hurt, do they?
Are your few coins worth more than 100 gold dragons?
What do you mean?
A man disappeared. A man named Garwin Sarwick. You know what I'm talking about, I presume? That man has a lot of people looking for him. People who are ready to lay down some gold.
Who would put a bounty of 100 gold dragons on my brother's head? That's madness!
'Twas the Watch, pretty boy, and none other. Your brother is accused of killing Lord Sarwick of Riverspring. A damned kinslayer.
I still fail to understand the link between the reward for my brother and me. No one has put a bounty on my head as far as I know.
Perhaps. But you must know where he is. If you don't want to tell us, we'll spread the word that we beat you to a pulp. So your brother will show his face, and then we'll have him.
Let's just do this.
Since I can't reason with you, let's settle this with steel. The Light of R'hllor will welcome you home.
Right. Once I've broken all of your teeth, you'll beg me to release you to your god.
Oh, shit. Yeah, let's take out the main bad guy first. I think I might die here. They're all flammable now. Why is that guy just dodging everything? That was close.
Halt! What's going on here? Disarm yourself immediately in the name of the king.
Shit! Gold cloaks! We'll see you again, lordling. The Reapers never forget an enemy.
Can you explain all of this to me, my lord?
These brigands attacked me, and had you not intervened, they would have gotten the punishment they deserve.
The Watch does not look kindly upon those who take justice into their own hands, my lord. I would advise you to keep your weapons sheathed and keep a low profile. Whatever the case, your attackers bolted like rats. Do you have any notion of who they were?
They claim to be called the Reapers. Does that mean anything to you?
Perhaps. A couple of useless brutes and thieves who crawl through the city sewers. Petty thugs for the most part. Their boss must be quite clever to still be working after all these years. But we'll get them sooner or later, trust me.
Sir, just a groat for some food. Okay guys, we're going to leave that there for today. I want to say thank you to everyone, as always, who's watched this video, and make sure you like and subscribe.